My whole science and ideology out of line. I pick it up where it's at, and I don't press rewind. I don't do no resolutions, I do the grind. And it ain't never nobody fault, it's always mine. I'm a nigga from the head to the floor, and ain't no bitch defining me but the neck of my horse. I don't blame nobody for actions, I only react. Send me all those Macs so I can do the deactivations on these D-apps. Play me if you want, I give you 6 months in a hurry and then it's one. Peace, God, it's fucked up how I did that, nigga. But peace, y'all, you see how I don't see that, nigga? Shit come around in trays, AKs, or Mac 11s. Or do you dirty old school like Smith & Wesson's? It's easier to see the thugging in the vein. Cause every word I sketch on the paper, you feel the pain. Wash my face when I wake up, then bag the apes. Brush my teeth, kiss my daughter on her face, and then I skate by God's grace. I send up a prayer, and then I cake. Early in the morning until the break of the day, nigga.
Liquor, puppies, and weed. I'm ecstatic about it. It's super, super official. We took a lot of time to come up with the concepts, come up with the content and overall, and not just because it's mine, you know what I'm saying, but because it's a mean project. And I appreciate those who went out their way to show love to it, to critique it, and it's doing fantastic on Spotify, it's doing awesome on iTunes, just beginning to generate some good income and paying bills. Liquor, puppies, and weed, man. This is a Maltese and a Maltese mix. And it's dope. Oh, Yorkie. So they call it Morky. So Maltese and Yorkie mix. That's what we have available. Okay, this one is very delicate. And go rock with me for this podcast.
I ain't rushing for niggas. In any case, you see a song, blame me. Word to mother, y'all know my shit ain't a song. Look around, y'all niggas know what the fuck going on. Blame me. I'm kicking that old Quran, blame me. That first Corinthian rap, Al-Qaeda bombs, blame me. Leave the competition resting in peace. It ain't your fault, fuck boy. Blame it on me.
You ain't gotta look, so I'm walking backwards. Keep walking, walking faster, walk faster. Cakewalk alumni, walk fast. Cakewalk alumni, and then make a left. This is what we doing. We have the mixtape DVDs. Get on the sidewalk so you can get hit. We got the mixtape DVDs. I'm not gonna say nothing else, you gotta just walk back. Mixtape DVDs, okay? Right here, with my man Mac. And what we're doing is, we're contributing to our coaches. This is Black CEOs, okay? And what we're doing is, we're representing Cakewalk.
Yeah, call me, man. 347-995-6755. I want to make some announcements. Aside from the mixtape, what we're broadcasting now is coming every Sunday. We've decided to hone in on every Sunday, and 10 o'clock, so that we could have a dialogue. I mean, we could talk, chop it up. Okay, and that's what we're going to do today. I want to discuss. I want to discuss two things. I'm going to give you some background before we go into a deep dissertation of it. First off, it's a question, and the second piece to the curriculum that we are going to be presenting now is food for thought. A question and food for thought. Let's do it. The question now comes from childhood. it's a question that is normally asked at a child, at the childhood time of when you were a kid. And enthusiastically, without even hesitation, the kid would raise his hand, she would raise her hand, and they would immediately respond ecstatically. Can't wait till they're called and selected so that they can have a turn at the question being asked. And children is a wonderful thing because it's pure and it's not influenced yet when this kind of question is presented and asked. You know what I mean? This is their answer. And along life's journey, when we become an adult, that answer begins to disappear. It is some from when you was a child to the adult stage. It you're looking at it like, what in the world? What happened? You know what I mean? Why are you answering? Why is your answer completely out of this world now? From when you was a child. You understand what I'm saying? I'm gonna pause there and go into the second topic. The second piece of the curriculum, which is the food for thought.
Shit now, so enough. Go second niggas bustin' if you fuck the weight up, like you don't know that I'ma buy my money, buy my money. I read to some buy money.
Bonkers that off the wall. Then they Capone up and rockin' at Havistraw, New York City. I'm hoping they chant after my rant, after I break the competition. The facts is for my advance, nigga.
Follow the train of thought. Now the question at hand, the question now is, what is this question, right? The question is, when you were a child, childhood question. Young man, princess, young lady, what would you like to be when you grow up? Right? And then the hands is all up like this, because, you know, I know what I want to be. I know what I want to be. And the crazy thing is, they answering the question. It's not even a thought. It's not, they don't, let me see, let me think. Nah, I want to be a teacher. I want to be a professional baseball player. I want to be a doctor. I want to be a lawyer. I want to be a police officer. You know what I mean? Like,
a baby doctor. I want to be really, really rich so I could have slumber parties in my giant mansion.
But I don't know what I'm going to be when I grow up. I want to be an engineer, the kind that like makes the trains and designs them.
I really want to be a pet store owner.
Astronaut.
It's without thought, right? Childhood question. Fast forward to adult. Why are you a janitor now? Why are you in the basement somewhere going from office rooms, changing garbages, hunched over, switching out light bulbs? Why are you now a cashier somewhere down south at Winn-Dixie as a cashier? What has happened to you? Why in the world? Why is there such a contrast? Why are you an assistant manager at Family Dollar? What in the world has gone on with you from the childhood confidence? I know what you're checked out. I want to be. And now, with all of this intelligence you would assume as an adult, now you at Home Depot stocking shelves, bro. What has happened? In the defense of a child, see, when you're a child, before you get this influenced and bombarded by the safety advice of adults, the child knows innately or instinctively, without thinking about it. And the second piece of information was the food for thought. Now, as an adult, we have all this rationale.
Show a lot of love right now. We want to give shout outs to Mel Maxi. I gotta meet you, my king. The brother put me on to you. We gotta come out to more of the areas of Harlem. Okay, we want to take it to the inner cities. But what we're doing, we're showing the black CEO movement, Black Lives Matter. Okay, because it really does matter. You gotta understand what we're doing. First and foremost, we'll be putting out. Max book in the summertime.
Yes, the book is coming out soon.
Yes,
this June.
Yes,
Hell Up in Harlem. Mm-hmm. Shout out to Mino, you know, Glow Flow Entertainment, Mel Maxi, you know, Harlem American. You know, this is what we're doing. You know, sometimes a lot of people don't really understand the grind and the work ethic, you know what I'm saying, that the brother Ali put into our business.
Yes, sir.
Like, you know, I learned what I got from him.
Okay.
You know, my people just encouraged me to keep further going in my movement, but I got the business from Ali.
Okay. Applaud your hands when I step to the grandstands of fans, kicking that street shit to the can. Like I'm from Harlem, like Cam, like I got stacks of rubber bands around that grip of my grands.
All this rationale as to why, you know, I was a kid, I didn't know no better, I didn't know what I was saying. I beg to differ, bro. I beg to differ, sis. You know exactly what you wanted at 7, and 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I mean, you knew, you know what I'm saying? As the pollution of vice, as the pollution of peer pressure, as the pollution of it's too hard. See, as a child, it's a struggle, or it's this or that. But as a child, it wasn't even a concept. It's too hard. It's a struggle. Kids don't even think like that, B. That those infirmities, those insecurities, those talking to yourself, bad affirmations, man, that pollution, that toxicity, man, starts coming on us as we grow or get older. Not even grow, you're just getting older numerically. You're not growing. That's 97% in the study that I've been doing, man. This research that I've been doing. 97% of people are doing what everyone else is doing, man. I remember, just me personally, 9, 10, 11. I wrote down Nas, that one love. Verse for verse, hook, everything, you know what I'm saying? Damn, boom, you be out soon, stay strong. Out in New York, the same shit is going on. The crackheads talking, loud mouths is talking. Yo, check out the story yesterday when I was walking. The nigga got shot last year trying to appear like he heard something. Word the mother heard him fronting. He was pumping on your block. Your man gave him your Glock, and now they run together. What up, son? Whatever. Since I'm on the streets, I'ma put it to it. I'm doing the same thing now that I said I would do at the talent show, doing the scenario song for the talent show that I won first place in. You know what I'm saying? Here we go, yo. Here we go, yo. So what's the scenario? I mean, bro knows this, what? And bro knows that, what? And bro knows that. So, the point, case in point B, I'm doing every bit of what I said I was going to do. You know what I'm saying? Every bit of it. why aren't you doing your childhood knew the answer to the question of what do you want to be when you grow up? What has happened to you, man? Sister, what has happened to you? Now, if you're doing what you're doing, it's the butterfly. But if you're not, pay attention to every word in this dissertation, man. And get back to that childhood-like faith, that childhood-like belief. You know what I'm saying? At the edge of the pool, and auntie or your moms or whoever the case may be, got their hands up, and without thought, you just jump. You know what I mean? Into their arms. Without thinking too much, man. You know what you wanted to do, sister. You know what you wanted to do, brother. You know what you wanted to do. Why you not doing it? Cakewalk alumni, man. Food for thought. That's the question.
I'm on the stage, I sat and wait till my pants, the gauge is tucked by the Levi stamp. I see my fans singing, I'm still bringing that retarded, he ain't got sense. Still meeting up with my mans by Central Park bench. Still kicking that redundant, moving crack valves like Frank Lucas back when he had it, holding that Mac down. Still singing that Al Pacino, that gangster shit. Lafayette, that's what it is.